Hi guys, so today I'll be doing a video on how to tell if your bearded dragon's a boy or a girl, and what to feed your bearded dragons, and how to clean their cage. So first, let's start off with the food. Well, here's your water. So if you have to have a spray bottle like this, and if you don't have a spray bottle, I'd recommend getting a water bottle from PetSmart or really anywhere that you got your bearded dragon. So if you don't have a spray bottle, which this is the same spray bottle I used for the tray frogs, but if you don't have a spray bottle, then I just recommend using a water bowl. So, second thing is, if you have a baby bearded dragon, they love this bearded dragon food. So, it is called juvenile bearded dragon food. I got it at PetSmart. And this one too, it's great for grown-ups and babies. It is called juvenile bearded dragon food again. It's fortified daily diet. I feed it to them every day. And Armstrong mealworms, they're live mealworms. They aren't big ones, but they're tiny. And my bearded dragons love them. And sometimes I feed them to my bluegills. They like them too. And freeze-dried mealworms. I'm almost out of these because he likes them so much. And everybody has to have their veggies. So you get them some mixed greens and that will be all set. And if you want to have crickets, it's a very big challenge. So, because if you don't take good care of them, if you don't take the exact right care of them, they will die. So, right here, what you need to do is you need to get a spray bottle and spray them down every day, which you can also use for your bearded dragon, like I said. And you need to get some high calcium cricket diet and then just sprinkle it in there when you first get them. I go on this one website and you can get 1,000 for $50. It's really good. So now let's get on to the cleaning thing. So if you're going to clean it, you do the exact same thing you do as a tree frog's cage. If you take the soil out, and if you don't have any more soil, you wash it out. Same thing on my other video. So you just wash the soil out, and then put it back in once it dried out. Get all the water out. And then again, if you have more soil, just like put it, the other soil in the trash and put new soil in there. And then, after you're done, well, first you want to take all the stuff out, then you take the soil out. But first you want to get your bearded dragon, put it on your bed. He'll really stay anywhere as long as you don't put him on the floor. So then after you take the bearded dragon out, put him wherever you're putting him. Then you take all the stuff out, your decorations, and then you put him on a towel and bring him to the bathroom and wash them all off because he loves to use it, but he gets dirt all over it. My bearded dragon, his name is Lucky. So then you wash it all off. Then after you got the soil back in there, you put it all back, and then you just put it, your bearded dragon back in there. It's pretty simple. And then if you have soil, if you just use this mat, then you can wash it off easily, and then you have to get all the stuff out, like crickets and stuff if you use them. You see, if you use live stuff like this, say I put this kind of stuff in there all the time, like stuff that's not alive, then it wouldn't go into the mat. But if I use big mealworms and these little ones, then they would go under the mat. And if you use crickets, they'll go under the mat too. And crickets in there know how to dig, so it's a pretty good challenge if you're up for it. Like if you get crickets, they'll go in really small places, and then your bearded dragon won't be able to eat them. But if you get normal food that doesn't move, then your bearded dragon will just sit there, so your bearded dragon will be able to eat it. But they like stuff that moves. So, it's a pretty hard challenge because every time you have to dig it up and find the stuff. Sometimes they just hand feed them so they don't run away. That works too. But if you're scared of hand feeding them and you're afraid they'll bite you, then you can just sit it down. So, now I will show you how to make your bearded dragon. And after I get my bearded dragon out, if you're going to keep your bearded dragon, you got to know its gender so you can name it, right? So I named this one Lucky, because it has survived 2 cat attacks. Yeah, he's very lucky, actually. So, if you look right here, if there's bumps on the side of the tail, that means it's a... If there's bumps right here, that means it's a boy. But if there's bumps in the middle, that means it's a girl. Now, he doesn't really like when I do that, so I can't do it for very long. But it's very challenging to keep a bearded dragon. It's very fun, too. Get off me. It's very fun, too. Because you gotta have a heat lamp. And then when your heat lamp comes out, you gotta go get it. And they poop a lot. And you have to give them baths weekly. But, yeah, it's obviously worth it. Because they are obviously so cute. And, did you know that he started off this big? All the time when I walk in the PetSmart to get my stuff, I always see the baby ones and they're always so cute. But, thank you for watching this video. I hope this helped you out. See you tomorrow. Bye.